stars look like they're not shining. Her hair falls perfectly without her trying. She's so beautiful, and I tell her every day. Yeah, I know, when I compliment her, she won't believe me. And it's so sad to think that she don't see what I see. But every time she asks me, do I look okay? I say, when I see your face, there's not a thing that I would change, 'cause you're amazing, just the way you are. And when you smile, the whole world stops and stares for a while, 'cause girl, you're amazing, just the way you are. Yeah. Her lips, I could kiss them all day if she'd let me. Her laugh, she hates, but I think it's so sexy. She's so beautiful, and I tell her every day. Oh, you know, I never ask you to change. If perfect's what you're searching for, then just stay the same. So don't even bother asking if you look okay. You know I'll say, when I see you.
dear friends and family, we're gathered here today to, with the objective of uniting the marriage, Jillian and Michael, who have decided to change their civil status from single to the honorable status of being married. Marriage is an institution. It is an honorable status which has its origins in the solemn contract celebrated between one man and one woman who of their own free will wish to marry with the object to love, honor, and care for each other mutually. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It is not proud. It is not rude, nor self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. To celebrate this marriage, it is necessary that there is no opposition. So if anyone here knows of any legal reason to prevent this event, must speak now or forever hold silence. Michael, do you take Jillian to be your wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish always?
I do.
Jillian, do you take Michael as your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish always?
I do.
Jillian, you may say your personal vows.
Michael, today I have loved you for 2,263 days, and they have been the best days of my life. Who knew a game of drunken go fish would lead to this amazing life with the most amazing daughter? Today, I choose you to be my husband. I promise to walk through life by your side, hand in hand. I promise to comfort you in times of need and in times of loss. I promise to listen to you in times of distress. I promise to tell you that I love you every day and kiss you goodnight. I promise to laugh at all of your inappropriate jokes. I promise to always be the mother that Leighton needs and deserves, and to always put you two first. I will always be honest with you and forever faithful. I have always and will continue to appreciate you more than you know. I will never stop believing in you. I vow to love you deeply and unconditionally for the rest of my life. I can't believe this day is finally here. Michael, it's always been you. This is my fairy tale ending. You are my dream come true. I love you.
Jill, when I sat down to write these vows, I never realized how hard it would be. To put into words how I feel about you is easy, but narrowing it down to just a few things is the hard part. I knew you were the one since our first date at the zoo, even though it's go fish. Here we are 6 years later, and you are still the first person I want to see in the morning. And the last person I want to see at night, even though that's usually her. They say opposites attract, and that stands true with us. You truly are my better half. Still can't believe you actually agreed to marry me. Being that you know me so well. Past year threw us some curveballs, but it was your strength and courage that got us through it all. I am not sure a lifetime is long enough for me to give you all that you have given me, but I can promise you that I will spend every day trying. I love you.
The rings, please. The ring is a symbol of unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. May these rings always remind you of the vows that you are taking. Michael, please place a ring on the wedding finger of your wife and repeat after me.
I give you this ring as a sign as my devotion and love, and with all my heart. I promise you all that I am. May this ring always remind you of the vows that I have taken.
Jillian, please place the ring on the wedding finger of your groom and repeat after me.
I give you this ring as a sign of my devotion and love. And with all my heart, I promise you all that I am. May this ring always remind you of the vows I have taken.
Jillian and Michael, if there's anything you remember of this marriage, may it be the love that brought you here today. It is only love we can make a glorious union. Today, your separate lives with your individual memories, desires, and hopes are merged into one. You're now taking into your care and committing to keeping the happiness of that person who will walk along the way with you during your holy life. Love is more than a feeling. It is a commitment. A commitment to work things out and to resolve the issues, to communicate even when it's hard to, and to forgive each other so you can have a fresh start each day. Good marriages take time and effort to be built and nurtured, and it can only be done based on tolerance, respect, and understanding. May that special love you now share continue to grow and blossom in the years to come. May it be sustained by family and friends, and by the commitment you're making today. Because you have promised each other your love, devotion, and commitment, having heard from the couple they wish to marry, and having heard no opposition to their marriage, today, May 24th, at the majestic Mirage in front of your family and friends, we now pronounce you husband and wife. Michael, you may now kiss your beautiful wife. Congratulations!
When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see, no, I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid, just as long as you stand.
I will now introduce, for the very first time in Punta Cana, Dominican Republic, Mr. and Mrs. Van Sciver. Congratulations!